Disposal is broken. You're the landlord. It's your job to make sure it works.
It never worked before.
Neither did I. But if I have to, so does it. Where's Austin?
That would be in Texas. South of Dallas, I think. You planning a trip?
I don't pay you to be funny. You're the nanny.
Whoa. Wait a minute. Don't ever call me the nanny. You could call me Marion. You can call me Sir. Or you can call me what all the ladies call me, Mr. Goodbar.
Where is Austin?
Oh, I get it. Your ex-husband got the house and the sense of humor.
This is the last bag. Well, come on, Marion. You're gonna help me do that thing, remember?
Oh, yeah, right, that thing.
Austin! Don't I get a hug? Oh, my God, Austin, what happened to you?
A sixth grader named Terry.
Austin just got into a little rumble.
About what?
I didn't get Terry's homework done on time, and I was a little short on lunch money.
He's taking your lunch money? That's it. I'm going down to that school, and I'm cracking some heads.
See? I told you.
You told him what?
No, Austin said you'd go down to the school and pull a Mrs. Lionel Richie.
No. I won't do that again. That's how my ex-husband wound up with the house.
Don't do anything. Besides, Mary said he'd give me some advice.
Yeah, I have some experience with bullies.
Was someone picked on you when you were small?
Not exactly.
Oh, you knew how to defend yourself.
No, I was just never small. And I don't believe in physical force as a way to solve anything.
Excuse me, you don't believe in physical force? You were a professional football player.
When I played football, I never intentionally tried to harm anyone.
Oh, what, did you just walk up to the opposing players and say, please lie down?
Yes. I mean, a lot of your better players don't fall for it, you know. I just think in real life there's better ways to handle bullies than resorting to their tactics.
Wuss. Come on, Austin. Mommy's gonna show you some moves.
Couldn't I just go to night school?
Oh, come on, honey. We need some kicking and swinging room.
Hey, don't forget whose house this is. You break it, you bought it.
Well, let's say that Terry is coming up behind you, right? And you're gonna turn around and swing that leg like a bat.
Ooh. Tell me again why your ex-husband left you.
Now, come on, honey. You give it a try.
Couldn't I just challenge Terry to a spelling bee?
I don't think this is the way to handle the situation.
Oh, well, how did you handle it with your children? Oh, that's right. I forgot. You don't have any, Mr. Goodbar.
I don't like the way you said Mr. Goodbar. But I'm going to help you anyway. Austin, what you need is an attitude that tells this guy, hey, you better not mess with me, that you're the man.
I'm the man?
Yeah, but say it like you believe it and without the helium. I'm the man.
I'm the man? I'm the man.
Yeah, honey, that's good. Now just put a little attitude in your walk, you know. I'm the man. Don't mess with me now.
But not like you got rocks in your shoes. More smooth, you know. I'm the man. Don't mess with me now.
Okay.
Come on.
I'm the man.
I'm the man.
There you go.
Don't mess with me.
Yeah, come on, more. No, I'm the man.
No, I'm the man.
Come on.
No, I'm the man.
I'm the man.
I am the man.
You know I'm the man.
Austin, why don't you go upstairs and practice that in your mirror upstairs, and I'm getting scared of you.
Take it easy. Say something for tomorrow. Poor kid is gonna get his drawers pulled over his head.
Next. You got my homework?
You talking to me?
Hello? Do you see any other little peanut head around here? I said, where's my algebra?
I'm in fourth grade. I haven't even taken algebra yet.
Yeah, but like you, you're such a genius. So where is it?
You've pushed me too far. A man can only take so much humiliation.
You thinking of changing your long distance company?
No one ever calls me anymore. Nothing in my life is like it used to be.
Hey, we've all been there. Sometimes it helps to have someone to talk to, put things in perspective.
Thanks, Marion.
See, my boyfriend.
Whoa,
Kevin.
Whoa, not me. Freddie Fremont.
Who's that?
My psychic. He used to advise me on everything. If I called him before I filed my last tax return, we might not be having this conversation now.
I'll try anything.
Hey, Freddie, it's me. Marion. Takes him a minute to fire up the crystal ball. Yeah, it's been a while. Are you sure? I thought I paid you. Oh, so it's like that now. See if you can predict what I'm fixing to say about your mother. So you need some boyfriend advice?
Yeah. My boyfriend Kevin and I had a fight, and I told him to call me back in 20 minutes, and he hasn't called.
How long has it been?
21 hours and 32 minutes. 33.
See, what you're dealing with here is a classic power struggle. All you have to do is wait him out. He'll call. And when he does, you have him eating out of the palm of your hand. He'll fly you and your mother all over the world. Then you could dump him. Take his money. Keep the jewelry. And claim he lost his Earth, Wind, and Fire box set.
So I shouldn't call?
Call who? Oh, right. Don't call. Don't call.
Right. All right. But this isn't gonna be easy.
Hang tough. You can do this.
Austin!
Have you seen Austin?
I was gonna say yes, it's a beautiful city in the summer. But you don't look like you're in the mood. You never look like you're in the mood. That's why your husband left you.
I don't remember annoying me being part of your job description.
What's up?
I'm gonna take Austin over to this Terry's house and I'm gonna have it out with him and his parents.
Excuse me. You know, Eastern philosophy has taught me that it's wiser to allow one's enemy to be defeated by his own anger.
Where'd you learn that?
Kung Fu. First season before the stories got silly.
Well, Western philosophy says, fix the damn garbage disposal or I'm not paying the rent.
No, excuse me, no. Technically, that's South Central philosophy. Where's my monkey wrench?
Mom, do we have
yes,
to?
Yes, we have to. Do you want to spend the rest of your life cowering in fear, hovering in the shadows, worrying that around every corner there's some bully waiting to pounce on you?
It's gotten me this far.
Austin, if there's one thing I've learned in life, is that sometimes you have to face your problems head on.
Yeah.
Hi there, I'm Jackie Warren, and this is my son, Austin.
Look, if you're selling cookies, I don't eat sugar. You're selling magazines, I don't read.
No, I just want to talk to you.
And if you're one of those religious kooks, I'm a devil worshiper.
Are you Mrs. Randolph?
Yeah.
I'd like to talk to you about your son, Terry.
My who?
Your son, Terry. May we come in, please?
Yeah, sure. TV's on the blink. And this sounds like it might be real good.
Oh, well, thank you. May I ask, is there a Mr. Randolph?
I'm sure there is somewhere.
Oh, well, as one single mother to another, I know that it's not possible for parents to be with their children 24 hours a day.
Thank God for that, huh?
And I'm sure you probably are not even aware of the fact that your son, Terry, has been picking on my Austin at school.
Is that right, Austin?
And I thought that maybe if we all came together and talked about it, we could come to some understanding. You have big hands. I bet you could palm a basketball.
State champs. Terry! Get out here!
I'm playing in a computer game. You brought your mom? I don't believe this.
Terry is a girl?
I'd like to see the DNA on that.
That's her, Mom. That's the kid who's been picking on me.
What? Picking on you? Look at the size of him. He's got arms like pipe cleaners. He only weighs 50 pounds. 10 of that is hair. When the Santa Ana winds blow, we have to keep him indoors.
Jeez, Mom. What do you say about me when I'm not here?
Listen, I taught Terry to look out for herself, and she's pretty good at it. Now, if your son is having a problem with her, maybe it's his problem.
Well, aren't you going to do anything?
No, I'm going to do something. I'm going to ask you to leave.
But we haven't solved anything.
I think we have. Your son obviously has a problem with assertive women. And now that I've met you, I can see why.
Is that so? Well, I have just one thing to say to you. And another thing. Oh.
Mom, how come you didn't spin around and use your leg like a bat?
Because I'm wearing a skirt. And I didn't want to take a chance breaking her porcelain Elvis. I think I made our point.
What was our point?
That in the face of unreasonable opposition, you can still stand up for yourself in a dignified and civilized manner.
Sure, Mom. I'm just glad they didn't have a trophy case.
Oh, what the hell? Run! 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 Marion?
What?
Kevin still hasn't called. You said he'd call.
I also said I could fix this thing. What do you need a garbage disposal for anyway? I never had one when I was growing up. It broke when I was 4. We didn't know who to call, so we got a dog. That dog is still gone. We only fixed it once.
Marion, Kevin is the man I love. He's kind, he's smart, and he works at the Gap.
You're not gonna wimp out and call him.
I think he suffered long enough.
Don't do it. Once you give up control, you'll never get it back. I made that mistake once in life.
Haven't you fixed this disposal yet?
Okay, twice. Look, to be honest, not only can't I fix it, I can't even put it back together. And frankly, your meatloaf wouldn't go down it anyway.
The problem is not my meatloaf. The problem is your mouth is running and not the disposal.
No, the problem is the earthquake hit and I can't unload this place. Now, I gotta get the kids to school. Where's Austin?
He's still in bed. He seems to have a fever.
Oh, so it's the girl bully thing, huh?
Some girls picking on Austin? Hasn't she got a brother of her own?
Come on, Tiffany. I'll take her to school. Marion, you stay here with Austin. Now, make sure he gargles with the garlic tea every half hour, a teaspoon of castor oil every hour, ice packs under his armpits, and don't forget to keep that mustard plaster on his chest.
So you think he's really sick?
Maybe. But if he's faking, he'll never do it again.
I hear you're not feeling well. Ooh. I also hear you're at level 6.
I really don't feel good. Mm. I got chills. I must have caught a bug.
Your mom said you had a fever.
Well, first I'm hot, then I'm cold. I must have 2 bugs.
You know, the Chinese believe that you can manifest emotional stress into a physical malady. Of course, they also believe that ill makes a delightful snack. So.
That's my story, and I'm sticking with it.
Well, drink your tea. Oh, I wanted to tell you, I think you handled the bully thing in an honorable way.
I didn't do anything but get beat up.
But you didn't hit her back.
Malto.